Okay, this is a video about the Diabetes Project, just to go over some key points and help people put this together. So this project will require you to do some research on your own. You're going to have to find out some information, or you're going to have to think and hypothesize, come up with an educated guess. So when we're doing this first part, blood glucose levels in the human body, we're going to create a graph representing your blood glucose levels, right? And we're going to make a hypothetical data set. So think about your blood sugar. When do you think it's high? When do you think it's low? It's going to get higher after you eat, especially if you eat a sugary meal. It's going to be lower after you've exercised or haven't eaten for a long time because you've done some work. In order to create this graph, you can make it by hand, but I think it's a lot cooler if you do it in a spreadsheet. So you open up a spreadsheet. I created two columns, one for hours of the day and one for my blood sugar in milligrams per deciliter. Wanted to choose those units because it told me those are some good units in a range of values where a typical person is going to have blood sugar concentrations that range from 70 to 130 milligrams per deciliter. So I'm using military time because 1 o'clock, that's 1 a.m. What do I think my blood sugar is? Probably pretty darn low. It's like, oh, maybe it's not 70. Maybe it is 80, right? Maybe it's 80 here and it goes down to 78 and 76. I'm just making up numbers, right? You can make up your own numbers. I'm just trying to give you an example of what I'm doing here. So I have some numbers now. I'm going to select my data. What we really want to do is make a graph with this. I select my data. I go to insert chart. What kind of chart do I want? Well, it tells me in the instructions that I recommend a smooth line chart. So I'm going to go ahead and select smooth line chart. When we're in here, I can go in here and customize. I could click here and change the text from hour of day. And I could like write in military time, or I could change the text of this. I could change the text by just double clicking and change my title to make it fancier, right? But for right now, I just want to look at what my data is doing. You can always get that menu back by clicking on the graph and going to edit chart, and the same information shows up again. So for now, what I want to do is scroll up to my data here. And as I put information in, the nice part about making the graph right away, let's say I get up at 6 o'clock and I eat some pancakes, right? So I get up, or a chocolate muffin or something like that. My blood sugar is going to skyrocket. I'm told here in this description that 130 is about as high as it's going to go. So I'm just going to say I just shoot right up to 130 again. See, it plots that graph live for me. And then I wash it down with some orange juice and whatnot. It might stay pretty high for a while. Maybe it goes to 120 and then it starts to drop really fast as my body responds to it. It goes down to 90. Right. And then by the time we get to 9 o'clock and second block, I'm kind of dragging. My blood sugar is really low again. I get to M block, go to the vending machine. And unlike what Mr. Bittman told me to do, I just get a sugary snack and some Doritos, right? And Twizzlers and Doritos. And my blood sugar just shoots right back up again to 130. And then it crashes, right? Really quick, because that was pure sugar. And I go right on down to 90 again and back to 70. My body might overcompensate and end up back at 60. And it gets to lunchtime, I just go straight for the cookies, right? My blood sugar goes up to 169, just absolute spike, and it slowly goes down, right, to 150, 130, right? And then I get to cross-country practice, and my day just goes, it drops really quickly, so I get down to 90, right? It stays at 90 for a little bit, maybe to 80, and then I get to dinner. You see, I have this graph, right? You can keep on making this. Have a reason for the numbers you put in. Your graph should not look the same as mine. You're going to have your own data, your own rationale. What time do you eat? What do you eat? What time do you do different activities throughout your day, right? So extend that all the way through. I stopped, right? The next part of this, so that's my graph. I'm going to take that graph from here. I edit the titles and all of that. I go to, I just copied. I selected it. I can just copy the graph, right, or Command C on my issue, and then go and paste it inside of here, and I've got my graph inside. Now I want to write an explanation, a one paragraph explanation, make some claim. I'm looking at my graph here thinking, man, my blood sugar goes up and down multiple times throughout the day based on my activity and my eating. That could be a claim. You might have a different claim. You might want to talk about how fastly it goes, or does it always go up and down at the same rate, whatever you got. The most important part for us here is evidence. What evidence do you have based off the graph? I see that my highest blood sugar of the day was at 1400 hours right here, right? then I could write reasoning. Why is that the highest? Well, why did I make that number there? What was my hypothesis? That I ate some sugary lunch, right? Or I look at the, I see that my lowest blood sugar was here. Or I see that my blood sugar steadily decreased while I was sleeping. Why did I say that, right? Those are all examples. I see in the graph, it means, right? I see, it means. You don't have to use those phrases. They're just a guide for you to help you write this one paragraph, C-E-R-E-R, for the blood glucose graph. So that's that part. The second part of the diabetes project has you make a Venn diagram comparing different types of hormones, some which are amino acid based, like insulin and glucagon, and some which are steroid hormones, like cortisol. To do this, to make this Venn diagram, I suggest you insert a drawing. So I'm going to insert drawing, new, right? And inside this drawing function, I can take a shape, like, I don't know, a circle or an oval, and I can draw one circle, right? And then I can change this background like that. And I can actually make it transparent, right? And I can take another circle, shape, so come on, shape, circle, right? And I can make another circle. I can move it around later. I want to make it transparent so I can type over it. And this is going to be a Venn diagram. I can put a text box inside this diagram, and I can talk about amino acid hormones, right? And what do I know about amino acid hormones? I can type all this into the box. I can resize these things. I can change the text size. I don't need to be size 14. I can change that so I can fit it inside here, right? And I'm just going to write, what do I know about amino acid hormones, and fit in this box. If I want to change the size of the circle, I can resize the circle, right? Give myself room to type, right? So what do I know about amino acid hormones? Well, I'm told some examples. Right here in the document, I was told that examples of them are insulin and glucagon, right? And I might want to look those up. I'm told that they're amino acid hormones. That means they are proteins, right? So all that you should be able to get from what was written inside. And you could write this out better than I am. I'm just doing a sloppy copy example for you, right? What else do I know about protein hormones? I know that they are polar, right? Which means that they are going to be soluble in water. But also it means that they're going to be unable to diffuse through the cell membrane, right? So in order to enter a cell, they require what's called a receptor, another protein to let them in. They require a receptor protein, right? And those receptor proteins are special, just like a change all of this sizing, of course, to make this fit. A receptor protein is a protein that's specific to a molecule that lets it in, like a sodium ion channel is specific to sodium ions. There's going to be a receptor protein just for insulin that lets insulin in the cell, and another receptor protein just for glucagon. Because these hormones require a receptor protein, they are not going to go into every cell. They're only going to affect some cells, not all cells, right? So they're only going to have an effect, and it's an affect, not an effect, on some cells, right? Now I'm going to do the same thing over here for hormones that are steroid hormones, right? What are my steroid hormones? I know my example was cortisol, right? I know it's going to be a lipid because it's a steroid, and I know all steroids are lipids. I know that means it's nonpolar, right? And if it's nonpolar, it's going to dissolve right through the cell membrane. It's going to enter all cells through the cell membrane. Again, I'm doing a sloppy copy. You can write this all out, right? No special receptor needed for cortisol, right? Then in the middle here, I need another text box that here, what do all hormones have in common, right? What do all hormones have in common, right? I can write that out. Hormones are signals sent from one part of the body to another. Again, you can look that up and you can make this nice. When you make it, and I could put another text box up here for a title. I could title it above, or I could have my text box at the bottom, wherever I want it to be, to either have a title or a caption underneath this. Save and close it. There it is. Now I can resize it to whatever thing I want it to be, position it how I want it inside of here. These are all terrible options. Let's just kind of have it break the text, and I'll put it in here like this. Once I have that, let me get it out of the way, making a mess of this. Once I have this Venn diagram, below it, I can just type some text, and you're gonna have to do some research here. What's the cause and effect of insulin release? What causes insulin to be released? Is it high blood sugar or low blood sugar? What effect does insulin have on the body? Does it increase the amount of sugar in the blood, or does it decrease the amount of sugar in the blood? What organs is it being sent from? What organs is it being sent to? Likewise, the cause and effect of glucagon release and the cause of cortisol release, and what effect does it have? So you can research those. These are very common hormones. You'll find them. The last part of the diabetes on human populations is to go find a picture of a graph or chart online that has to do with human populations and diabetes. So you just search that, find it, insert the image of that graph, give the whole MLA citation, right? You're not required to do any citations for this previous part about what these hormones are, but for this picture, I want you to give a citation. So if you need to look up how do you cite an image from the internet, look that up. How do you do a proper citation for that? And put that in there. Because just like text is intellectual property, so is an image. You should be able to cite that when you use it if it's not yours that you created. And then once you have your graph, you're going to describe two pieces of information that you see in it, just like we did for the graph that you created earlier with your blood sugar. You don't have to use the phrases I see and this means, but you're certainly welcome to. What we want to have is you're identifying evidence, specific details shown in that graph, and then you're explaining what you think those details mean or the implication of that data. That's what we're doing by describing two pieces of information. That is the Diabetes Project. You're going to learn a little bit about hormones and quite a bit about diabetes in order to do that. If you have any other questions, of course, you can always ask.